TV's most loved characters labelled as the new McDreamy. So when Patrick from Offspring was killed off, women everywhere went into meltdown.
It was the death that shocked Australian audiences to the core.
This is quite extraordinary. We do have some breaking news for you today. Dr. Patrick Reed from Offspring is dead.
The sudden passing of Offspring's Patrick Reed left all of us pining for a Matthew and Nevez fix.
We did everything we could, but he didn't survive the procedure. I'm so sorry.
Since then, Matt's followed up with other successful roles on shows such as Love Child, Paris War, and Hell's Sack, playing the fantastically great Dennis Lilly.
Gives me something to aim at.
Soon, Matt's going to return to our screens as motor racing legend Peter Brock, and he's starring in a brand new Aussie drama series, The Kettering Incident. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the amazingly talented Matthew Lanevez.
You just sat down where you sat. Oh, careful. It must be terrible being so ugly.
What? You would know. Please, come on. No, it's quite an intro, wasn't it?
Yeah. I think Dr. Patrick needs to check Denise's pulse. Yeah. How's it going? Is it still blood?
No, I wasn't anaesthetist, so maybe I could knock you out.
No, but the thing is, you've been in so many shows and you've killed them in each one of them. Each one you've been fabulous.
Yeah, I've killed them or they've killed me.
No, you know what I mean. You've just been brilliant.
Do you feel any sneezes coming on tonight?
I was going to say. I thought she was about to sneeze.
It's so lovely to have you on the show.
Thank you.
And because everyone...
We need the jumper.
Yeah.
Let me know, mate, if you want me to cut it. I'll just
I mean, people were devastated when you died. Yeah. I mean, your character did, but
the New South Wales Police Force had to put out a press release.
Yeah.
When you died on the show,
it went crazy for a long time.
A press release.
Yeah, they actually had to put it. The police had to put out a press release saying he's not really dead.
Stop calling
us. It's just an actor. Stop calling us. We're not going to investigate.
Yeah. No way. Yeah.
A lot of crazy things happened. I had people asking for my hand in marriage and all kinds of...
After you died?
Like donor sperm and all kinds of crazy things.
Wow.
Yeah, it was an interesting couple of weeks.
Oh, wow. My goodness.
But then when you were pregnant, when you were alive in the character... And you were pregnant, did they send in booties and stuff for the baby?
No, there was a lot of gifts sent and stuff like that for the child, but thankfully I wasn't pregnant, so...
No, you know.
As an actor, though, how do you... I mean, it's a bit of a double-edged sword, isn't it? On one hand...
it's a little bit bizarre. Just a little.
You've got the character of Patrick to thank for making you famous, but on the other hand, it's hard to shake that character and go into new roles. Yeah. Is that tough, sort of always being known as Patrick from Offspring?
It can be, but I also think it's exciting to be involved in a show that did find an audience. So you can look at it one way and feel like you might get defined by something, and it certainly helped me maybe get a role in another romantic show like Love Child. Mm. But then you can push against that and define your career in other ways. And I know The Kettering Incident's certainly a different style of show, so I'm excited for that role to come out.
It looks incredible.
Yeah, it's set in
Tasmania. Mm-hmm. And it all looks, it's sort of mystery, thriller, a bit of sci-fi in there too.
Yeah, we subvert the genre a little bit through the series, but we're lucky enough to have incredible filmmakers shooting this. I mean, Rowan Woods and Tony Crowitz and Vincent Sheen, the producer, co-creator with Vicky, they've worked all around the world.
Wow.
And I mean, look at that.
Wow.
That's the Candlesticks, and Tasmania is really the star of the show. It's just this epic nature, and we've never shot a major TV production down there. So to have a crew go down there and shoot for 5 months with an incredible cast and great scripts, I think it might be a game changer. We'll hope. Yeah.
Well, the bottom of the world is a pretty scary setting, isn't it?
Yeah, and it really is. Once you get down beyond Tasmania, it's just pure wilderness, and we're filming in the mountains, and we're filming
on the coastline. It's a brilliant place, isn't it?
Oh, I loved it. I loved it, and the people down there embraced us for the whole time, and yeah, it was a really special experience.
And another small, little, middling bit part you're playing in the future, Matt. Peter Brock.
Yeah, just a small little icon that I don't need to, you know, screw up.
No pressure.
Yeah, no, that was a real honour. Mm. You know, last year we shot that in and around Sydney, and I got to meet a lot of, you know, people that Peter had affected. He seems to be one of those men that no matter whoever met him, whenever it was, even if it was 30 years ago, they remember that specific moment.
Wow. Yeah.
And to be able to play someone like that who changed the lives of so many people and transcended sport and tell his story and share it with a whole new generation, I can't wait. It's going to be a romp. It's going to be really quick and it's going to be a fun couple of
Do you like cars? Did you drive, do your own stunts?
Yeah, the cars are so unique and so special that they wouldn't let me do too many, but we still managed to put the pedal to the floor a few times. And I accidentally turned the wrong corner on the freeway once and drove the 1969 Monaro to almost halfway to Newcastle.
Well, James is a massive car fan.
Yes.
Aren't you?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. So I know some of those cars you've been driving to do that.
I was lucky. I drove the 69 Monaro, drove the Austin Healey in 68. Yeah. I drove the first two of the Taranas. I got to drive a VK. I sat in the Daytona coupe that he had the accident in because they rebuilt that. It was quite a profound experience for me. And,
absolutely.
And growing up, I think everybody knew who Peter was, but obviously now there's a whole new audience that don't, so it'd be nice to share that with them.
There are also a lot of sides to him as well. We've had Bev Brock on the show, and she's just fantastic. When you were researching the role, what did you find out about him? What's your sort of sense of the man?
Well, I think Peter's an incredibly complex man, and yet he's a man that always followed his heart, to his own detriment. I mean, he backed his own passion and heart against GM in the early 80s, you know, with the polarizer, which is part of our story. And I think someone that's so passionate about their beliefs, and it's a really unique individual. He's a really unique individual. So I was lucky enough to get to know Peter Champion, who knew Peter quite well, and also do a lot of research. There's obviously a lot of material on Brocky. Yeah. And then, I mean, I'm excited to see it. I know it's going to be later in the year, but we'll
kind of wait.
We'll look forward to that. Fantastic. Now, you speak French, don't you? Does that mean you're going to be doing some European movies?
is that a euphemism?
European
is that a job offer?
No, have you had the sort of carrot being dangled from America for movies?
Oh, yeah, I mean, I've lived there for a little while with my family, but I seem to be working here a lot more, and the quality of the work here is pretty good.
What she really wants to ask is, can you speak French?
Speak words to her.
Just watch out, she doesn't sneeze.
All right, je serai enchanté si vous voulez regarder le quatrième incident avec moi, suis joué.
Yes.
The real question is, can you kiss French?
Can I kiss French?
Yes.
You'll have to ask my partner.
Whatever language you speak, we are glad to have you back on our screens. Yeah. The Kettering incident will be on Foxtel come July. Matt, thanks so much for joining us.